As requested by you guys, I'll be covering mandible fracture today, but I won't be able to cover mandible fracture in detail because मुझे mandible fracture along with condyle पूरा cover करना है. So I'll be giving you an overview. I'll try to go through all the concept एक एक करके. कोशिश करूंगा एक घंटे में खत्म हो जाए because after this most probably I might not be available for lecture या फिर ज्यादा एक lecture के लिए मैं रहूंगा. So mandible, it is one of the most prominent bone on the face and it forms the lower one third of the face and it is the only bone that is on the face that is mobile that moves. आपके face पे कोई भी और bone ऐसे move नहीं करती, only mandible is moving. Okay, so we're going to talk about some anatomy first, the parts of the mandible and some muscle attachments because these are going to play an important role in the fractures. कौन से fracture होते हैं, कैसे displacement हो रहा है, this is going to play an important role, the anatomy. So basically this is the mandible. इसमें दिस पार्ट सेंट्रल बिटवीन द सेंट्रल इनसाइजर, सेंटर में जो लाइन जा रही है द सूचर दैट इज सिम्फाइसिस. ओके, ना इसके लेफ्ट ना इसके राइट, इट इज सिम्फाइसिस एग्जैक्टली एट द सेंटर. ओके, फ्रॉम सिम्फाइसिस दिस लाइन टू मिडल ऑफ द कनाइन दिस इज कॉल्ड एज पैरासिम्फाइसिस. फ्रॉम कनाइन टू द एंटीरियर बॉर्डर ऑफ द रेमस, नॉट रेमस, एंटीरियर बॉर्डर ऑफ द मैसेटर मसल. मैसेटर मसल इज, मैसेटर मसल गोज लाइक दिस, राइट? सो anterior border of the masseter muscle tak we have the body. Okay, from the canine to the anterior border of the masseter muscle. Okay, and from the area that is covered by the masseter muscle in the angle region, that is the angle. So that area is angle region and then this area is the ramus and of course this is the condyle and this is coronoid process. Okay, these are the bony landmarks and iske upar se we can decide kaun sa fracture hai. Okay, the fracture if it occurs exactly at the midline, it is symphysis. In this region it is parasymphysis, this region body, angle, ramus, condyle and coronoid. Okay, now isme ek aur cheez bachi hai, this is the alveolar process. Okay, so if the fracture occurs in this alveolar process only without including the basal bone, that is called as dentoalveolar fracture. Okay, this classification was given by Dingman and Natwig. Okay, that is one. So ये मैंने अभी बता दिया, क्लासिफिकेशन बाद में आएगा, बट ठीक है, यू गेट द पॉइंट. और सो दीज आर ऑल द एरियाज जो मैंने बताए. अनदर थिंग, कैन यू सी बॉडी ऑफ द मैंडिबल गोज लाइक दिस हॉरिजॉन्टली एंड देन वी हैव द रेमस दैट इज ऑलमोस्ट परपेंडिकुलर टू द बॉडी ऑफ द रेमस. ओके, दैट इज वन कि यहाँ पे एंगुलेशन चेंज हो रहा है, सो देयर इज अ शार्प एंगल हियर. ओके, सो एनी एरिया विद अ शार्प एंगल इज द एरिया ऑफ कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ फोर्स. अगर हम फोर्स लगा रहे हैं मैंडिबल पे, so the force gets usually concentrated here. One, okay. Second, I think we have the slides there. So anyways, I'll talk about this. ये जो मैंने बताया fracture का angle का. So in anatomy again another thing, mandible is weakest in the condyle region. इसमें मैंने लिखा नहीं है, but it is weakest in the condyle neck region, condylar neck region, and it is weak in angle and canine region also. Let me talk about the condyle first. So this is comparatively thinner as compared to the condylar head. Now this is also a protective mechanism, okay, for the skull base fracture, to prevent any skull base fracture. Because agar ye neck fracture nahi hoga, basically wherever the fracture occurs, jo force apply hua hai on the bone, it gets dissipated at that site. Okay, so suppose agar fracture yahan hua, the force that is coming from here, it gets dissipated here, so force yahan nahi jayega. Okay, so suppose we have a strong mandible, wo fracture in Europe, we apply force aur janbujh ke to force apply nahi kare because of trauma or interpersonal violence, force application hua and this doesn't get fractured. Now we have the condylar head in the glenoid fossa, right? So if the condyle or the mandible doesn't get fractured and the force doesn't get dissipated, kya hoga? This force will be transmitted to the skull. It will lead to skull base fractures, okay, and that is going to be more serious. So condylar neck being thin, it is a protective mechanism of the body. Okay, so jaise hi force application hoga, even if the fracture doesn't occur here, it is going to cause the fracture in this region and it will prevent the skull base fracture. Okay, that is one. Second, condylar fracture hoga ya nahi hoga, it is also dependent on the presence of third molar. ओके, आई टेल यू कैसे. इसमें दोनों कंसेप्ट आएंगे कि एंगल फ्रैक्चर कैसे होता है, कॉन्डाइल फ्रैक्चर कैसे होता है. नाउ कैन यू सी दिस, यहाँ पे नॉर्मली इतनी बोन होनी चाहिए इन द एंगल रीजन, बट बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द थर्ड मोलर वी हैव नो बोन इन दिस रीजन, राइट? सो यहाँ पे इतनी बोन आ रही है, सडनली वी हैव दिस मच बोन. सो देर इज लेस बोन इन द एंगल रीजन, स्पेशली इन केसेज वेयर द टूथ इज मीजियो एंगुलरली इम्पैक्टेड. ओके, इफ द टूथ इज वर्टिकल इट विल बी लाइक दिस, तो एंगल में बोन रहेगी. बट इफ इट इज मीजियो एंगुलरली इम्पैक्टेड, सो वी हैव लेस बोन इन द एंगल रीजन. नाउ इफ इम्पैक्टेड टूथ इज प्रेजेंट, तो फ्रैक्चर यहाँ हो जाएगा बिकॉज द बोन इज लेस हियर. सो द फोर्स इज डिसिपेटेड हियर, कॉन्डाइल फ्रैक्चर नहीं होगा. सो जैसा मैंने बताया, इफ द थर्ड मोलर इज प्रेजेंट, एंगल पे फ्रैक्चर होगा, कॉन्डाइल पे नहीं होगा, राइट, बिकॉज द फोर्स इज डिसिपेटेड हियर. बट इफ द थर्ड मोलर इज एब्सेंट, तो क्या होगा, द फोर्स गेट्स ट्रांसमिटेड हियर एंड कॉन्डाइल फ्रैक्चर अकर्स. समझ आया? सो इट इज डिपेंडेंट, द कॉन्डाइल फ्रैक्चर एंड एंगल फ्रैक्चर इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल है. जहां पे कॉन्डाइल फ्रैक्चर होगा एंगल नहीं होगा, एंगल होगा तो कॉन्डाइल नहीं होगा. ओके, सो दिस इज वन पॉइंट, दैट कॉन्डाइल इज द वीकेस्ट, कॉन्डाइल नेक इज द वीकेस्ट, एंगल इज वीक. And also in the canine region, let me see. Now in canine region, can you see the canine roots are comparatively longer as compared to the other roots. Okay. So, yahan pe bhi amount of bone is less. So, these are also more prone to fracture. So, parasymphysis of body fracture zyada ho sakta hai because of the presence or absence of canine. Okay. So, this was condyle is the weakest. Maine bhale yahan pe likha nahi hai. But condylar neck is the weakest point. And after that, we have the angle and the canine region that are weaker. Okay? So, now we come to the muscle attachments. So, there are two muscle groups. One is elevator that closes the mandible. Second is depressor that opens the mouth, that pulls the mandible down. Okay? So, in elevator, we have three muscles, temporalis, masseter and middle pterygoid. So, look at this animation. So, look at the animation. This is the temporalis muscle. So it contracts and closes the mandible. Okay, then we have the masseter muscle that arises from the zygomatic bone and zygomatic arch, and it inserts into the inferior border of the mandible and the posterior surface of the ramus. Okay, aisa. So can you see, ye jab contract hoga, it is going to close the mandible. Ye bhi contract hoga, it is going to pull the mandible up. It will close the mouth, elevate the mandible, right? And can you see, it is rotating like this. Aisa nahi ki down and up ja raha hai. Can you see, it rotates. It rotates back. फिर से दिखा देता हूं. Just look at the animation. Can you see? Rotates and then comes up. Okay? याद रखना कैसा force application रहता है. Then we have the medial pterygoid muscle. This is the medial surface of the mandible. Medial surface. So again the same thing. Medial pterygoid muscle origin is from the lateral surface of the medial surface of the lateral pterygoid plate, and it inserts into the medial surface of the ramus inferior border. Like so it's not straight like masseter ki ye vertically straight down aa raha hai. So masseter dekha jaye, it is just pulling the mandible up, sirf upar ki taraf pull kar raha hai. Okay, whereas medial pterygoid, let me show you the animation, it is going like this upward and inwards. So when it contracts, ye open karta hai. So basically this animation shows that the opening of the mandible is done by the lateral pterygoid, closing is done by medial pterygoid. So can you see, the direction is towards medial and superiorly. Okay, so when this muscle contracts, it not only applies the superior force, upward force, it also applies the force in the medial direction. Okay, so for some reason, agar isko hum break kar dein, alag kar dein, so the force applied by this masseter muscle is going to pull the segment upwards and inwards. Samajha? Upar aur andar ki taraf pull karega. Samajha? These are going to play an important role into understanding ki kaise fractures hote hain. Then we have the depressor muscles. In that we have major muscle that is lateral pterygoid, then mylohyoid, genohyoid and anterior belly of digastric. So again the same animation jo maine abhi dikhaya tha. This is the lateral pterygoid. When it contracts, it pulls the condyle forwards. Why? Origin is from the lateral surface of the lateral pterygoid plate, and insertion is at the pterygoid fovea, right? So when this contracts, it pulls the condyle medially. Can you see, it is also going medially. So it, if suppose ye fracture hai yahan pe, so the condylar head is going to be displaced medially and anteriorly. So anterior medial displacement hoga, until unless ye muscle break ho gaya for some reason, iske alawa aur koi displacement nahi hoga, theek hai, ya fir koi physical obstruction hai, impact ho gaya fracture, to alag baat hai. But if the fracture is free, fracture segment is free, it will be pulled medially and anteriorly. So displacement will be more common seen is anterior medial displacement in condyle fracture. Then we have the mylohyoid muscle and genohyoid. Okay, ye dono hi muscles, can you see, these are pulling the mandible downwards. Okay, samajh aa raha hai? Origin is at the medial surface of the mandible and insertion is at the hyoid bone. So it is going to pull the mandible down. And then we have this anterior belly of digastric, again hyoid bone ke andar hai the sling. So when it contracts, it is going to pull the mandible downwards. Okay, now if I have the diagram, so just imagine, agar, let's go back, we'll talk about this only. Now imagine there are some muscles, that is mylohyoid and geniohyoid and anterior belly of digastric, that are pulling it down, and we have the medial pterygoid masseter temporalis that are pulling it upwards. Okay, suppose yahan pe fracture ho gaya hai. So this segment is being pulled downwards and this segment is being pulled upwards. Okay, so ye aise rotate ho raha, ye upar pull ho raha. So yahan pe they are pressing against each other, but yahan pe they are being pulled away from each other. Samajh aa raha hai? So that is why we see tensile forces at the superior border and compressive, they are pushing against each other, compressing against each other, that is compressive forces at the inferior border. Okay, because of the presence of the muscles. Okay, anteriorly these muscles are pulling it downwards, and posteriorly the masseter temporalis and medial pterygoid are pulling it upwards. Okay, let's move forward. Okay, now mechanism of injury by Lindahl. First is when a moving object hits the mandible. Okay, isme most commonly seen fracture is parasymphysis or body fracture. Okay, the object, the person is stationary, wo khada hai, kisi ne hit kar diya. It's not only interpersonal violence, you're playing some sports, ball aake hit kar gai, right? So the object that is causing the trauma is moving, whereas the patient is stationary. So that is the first scenario. In this case, usually you see a parasymphysis of body fracture, and if the force is a little too much, then you can see associated opposite side angle or condyle fracture. Okay, because the force is being transmitted to opposite side. Idhar se maarenge, the force is transmitted to this side, right? So this is the result of direct trauma, and this is the result of indirect trauma, that is condyle or angle. Angle ka maine bataya na, angle and condyle. Agar third molar hai to angle fracture hoga, agar nahi hai to condyle fracture hoga. Okay, so agar yahan pe nahi bhi diya angle fracture, it is common sense ki yahan pe ho sakta hai angle fracture. Okay, second scenario is that the object that is causing trauma is stationary and the patient is moving. Okay, so suppose the patient falls down, parade ground fracture pada hoga aap logon ne, hai na? So patient falls down, hits the floor with the chin. Okay, usually this is the most common scenario when you're moving suddenly, aapko koi object se takra rahe ho, usually the chin, symphysis is the area of trauma. Okay, so most commonly you're going to see symphysis fracture, and mostly if it is a pure symphysis fracture ki straight midline mein fracture hai, then you're going to see bilateral condylar neck fracture. Okay, because that fracture is dissipated on both the side, distributed on both the side, and condylar fracture hota hai. Okay, again the same thing, angle bhi ho sakta hai, yaad rakho. And the third scenario is when the patient is moving and the object is also moving and they collide in between. So that is going to lead to a bilateral body or parasymphysis fracture and bilateral condylar fracture. Okay, so these are the three scenarios. Then we have some buttresses on the face, that is in the mandible or mid face. Okay, I hope you pata hoga. So these are buttresses, basically are thin bony region, cortical bones that are able to withstand the pressure, withstand the force that is being applied on the bone. Okay, so we have these horizontal buttresses and these sagittal and vertical buttresses. Ki yahan pe force jo hota hai, it is being transmitted along this region. Okay, so these are the buttresses. Ye maine already bata diya hai. Suppose we have a fracture here. Okay, so this segment is being pulled down by the muscles, that is geniohyoid, mylohyoid and anterior belly of digastric, and this is being pulled up. Okay, by the muscles that are, naam batao, masseter temporalis and medial pterygoid. Okay, so this is being pulled down, this is being rotated upwards. So aise ho raha hai, right? So this, ye dono ek dusre ki taraf force laga rahe hain, so that is compressive force, and these are being pulled away from each other, so this is tensile force. Okay, so aage chalke Shamphy's line ka concept aayega, where he is going to tell you ki kahan pe plating karna hai. Ideally you are supposed to plate in the region jahan pe these forces are neutral. So this is the line jahan pe it is neutral, these are equal to each other. Okay, agar aap yahan pe plating kar doge to plate is going to withstand the force, whereas if you plate the if you place a plate here, first of all you're a fool if you're going to place a plate here, because yahan pe roots hai, we have the roots of the teeth, hai na? If you place a plate and screw lagaoge, the screw is going to perforate the roots. That is one. Second, because of the tensile forces, plate pull ho rahi hai. There will come a time that the plate is going to break off. Okay, beech mein se. And again the compressive force, yahan pe agar aapne plate laga di, still this is going to open up. Okay? Now, ye cheez maine bata di hai, inferiorly there is compression. These are being pushed towards each other. These are being pulled away from each other. Okay? So, this is tensile force and this is compressive force. Okay. Now we come to the classification. First classification is by Krugers. Simple basic classification jo sare fractures mein use hota hai. That is simple compound, comminuted complex, impacted, ring stick, pathological. Ek ek karke baat karenge isme. So, first is simple or compound. That is based on whether the fracture is getting communicated with the outside environment or not. Okay. Simple is it is not getting communicated with the external environment. Compound is whether the fracture is, suppose yahan pe laceration hai, we can see clearly see the fracture site from outside. Okay, so that is compound fracture. But in our case, especially in mandible fracture till the angle region, usually it is always a compound fracture. Let me see a photo. Yeah, can you see this? Isme we have the symphysis fracture because of the presence of the PDL space. It's a fracture and because of the laceration, because of the PDL space, we have the communication. Agar ye laceration nahi bhi hota, because of the presence of the PDL space, we have the communication with the oral cavity. That is the external environment from the fracture site. Okay. So till the angle region, mandible fracture, they are all compound fractures. Okay. Then based on green stick fracture. So this is a green stick. Ped pe se tod ke agar aapne fracture ki ho, wo puri tarah se break nahi hoti. It gets bent. Maybe ek side pe it gets fractured, but puri tarah se fracture nahi hota hai. So this is a green stick. So similarly in a young patient, children or a young individual, the bone is very elastic. So kya hota hai na, let me see if I have that. Ki when the force is applied, the fracture is incomplete. One cortex gets fractured, but the other doesn't get fractured, just like a green stick. So that is why it is called as green stick fracture, where only one cortex is fractured. The fracture is not complete. Okay. So in this case, we have the superior cortex that is fractured. Inferior cortex is fine. So it is an undisplaced green stick fracture. Okay. Of course, green stick is going to be undisplaced. And in this example, usually in children, what we see is the force application hota hai. Lingually, cortex is fractured, but buccally it is fine. Okay. I didn't have the picture, so maine bas draw kar diya. Okay. Then we have complex fracture. Now there are two explanations given in different books. One is jo aap logon ko likhna exam mein, that is complex fracture is the one where there is associated vital structure injury. Okay. Then second definition of complex fracture is given by AO. It is an organization that gives out the guidelines for fractures, not only head and neck fracture, throughout the body. Okay. So they say that complex fracture is the fracture where there are two fracture lines seen at one site. Okay. So this, can you see there are two fracture lines? ये हो सकते हैं या इसी साइड पे वी हैव टू फ्रैक्चर लाइंस. सो दीज आर कॉम्प्लेक्स बाय द डेफिनेशन ऑफ एओ. बट आप लोगों को लिखना है दैट अ कॉम्प्लेक्स फ्रैक्चर इज द फ्रैक्चर विद एसोसिएटेड वाइटल स्ट्रक्चर इंजरी. ओके, सो दिस इज अनदर एग्जांपल ऑफ एओ कॉम्प्लेक्स फ्रैक्चर गिवन बाय एओ. ओके, देन वी हैव कम्युनिटेड फ्रैक्चर की फोर्स एप्लीकेशन वाज सो मच दैट द बोन इज ब्रोकन इनटू स्मॉलर पीसेस, वेरी स्मॉल पीसेस. अगर इसको हमने ओपन किया, सर्जिकली ओपन किया, ये सारे पीसेस हाथ में आ जाएंगे. सो दिस इज द आइडियल केस फॉर क्लोज रिडक्शन. इसको ओपन नहीं करना होता है. ओके, एंड देन वी हैव द पैथोलॉजिकल फ्रैक्चर दैट देयर इज अ ह्यूज ट्यूमर और अ सिस्ट इन द मैंडिबल. सो इतना बड़ा पैथोलॉजी था, सिस्ट था. सो देयर वाज वेरी थिन कॉर्टिकल बोन लेफ्ट इंफीरियरली. ओके, तो हल्का सा भी प्रेशर मारा वो ब्रेक हो गया. एंड मेनी ऑफ द टाइम इट्स नॉट ओनली द प्रेशर एक्सटर्नली, पेशेंट बाइट भी कर रहा है, बिकॉज ऑफ द अक्लूजल फोर्स इट कैन फ्रैक्चर. Okay, so this is pathological fracture. Okay, so this is the zoomed in view of the same thing. So this was given by Kruger, general classification, then anatomical classification by Dingman and Natwick. Already I've explained about this, so I'm not going to talk about this. Then unilateral, bilateral, ek side pe hai to unilateral, dono side pe hai to bilateral fracture ho jayega. We've already seen cases where the patient is moving and the object causing trauma is moving. We see bilateral parasymphysis fracture along with bilateral condyle also. Then this is important, favorable, unfavorable, depending on the displacement and ease of reduction. Okay, so in favorable and unfavorable also we see horizontal or vertical. Now horizontal fracture, it is somewhat like this. If you remember, you have the pterygomacetric sling. Basically, sling kya on the ramus, we have laterally the masseter muscle, medially medial pterygoid muscle, hai na? So it is pulling the ramus upward, rotating the ramus upward like this, right? So if the fracture line is like this, that is, it is going superior inferiorly from superiorly, that is posterior in the angle region, and anteriorly inferiorly in the body region, the fracture line. So if this rotates, it is going to push the segments towards each other, right? So this is favorable, it is not causing displacement. Okay, so this this is favorable, this is unfavorable. Here the movement is in the vertical direction, upward and downwards, hai na? But it is called as horizontal fracture. Mujhe confusion hota tha yaad rakhne mein, because the movement is in vertical direction. So the way I remember this is how we view the fracture line. So in this, you're going to view the fracture line, the line of sight will be horizontal. This is how I remember it. The line of sight is horizontal. Hum aise dekh rahe hain. So it is horizontal fracture. It may be favorable or unfavorable. Okay. In this, if the fracture line goes anterior to posterior, anterior upwards and posterior downwards, then the displacement is going to happen because of the pull by the pterygomacetric sling. Pterygomacetric sling ka matlab bas yahi hai ki masseter and medial pterygoid muscle ko hum ek saath ek naam de rahe hain. Bas. Aur kuch nahi. So pterygomacetric sling ki wajah se we are seeing the displacement. Okay. And not only that, during the surgery, this is going to cause problem for reduction of the fracture. Okay. So this is horizontally favorable and unfavorable. Then the same thing. Then we have vertical fractures. So this we are going to view from top to down. Okay. In this, the fracture goes from laterally anterior lateral to medially posterior lateral, bol sakte, posterior medial. It goes like this. Okay. Now we have the medial pterygoid muscle, jo maine bataya tha, it is going to pull the ramus upward and medially. Okay. So here you have to remember that medial pterygoid muscle is going to pull this segment medially. Okay. So if the fracture line goes like this, this is not going to rotate because ye yahan se impact hoga, correct? Okay. And if the fracture line goes like this, laterally it is posterior and medially it is anterior. So this is going to cause the displacement of the ramus medially. Okay, rotation of the ramus medially. So this is not causing displacement, whereas this is causing displacement. So this is favorable, this is unfavorable. Again, the line of sight is vertical, ki upar se hum niche dekh rahe hain. So this is vertical fracture. Okay, understood? And there's another example of favorable or unfavorable is the fracture line like this in the parasymphysis of body region. Okay. Another thing I want you guys to remember is, suppose there's a bilateral parasymphysis fracture. Okay. Yahan pe. So because of the attachment of the genohyoid muscle, okay, it is going to pull the, not only genohyoid, we have the anterior belly of digastric also. So ye fracture ho gaya, so it is loose. This segment is loose. So it is being pulled downward and backward, downward and backwards. Okay. Now that is one, ki ye displace ho jata hai. Second, the tongue is kept in position because of the mandible, because it is attached to the mandible via the genoglossus muscle. Okay. So as this segment moves backwards and downwards, the tongue falls back. So this is especially a problem when the patient is unconscious. Patient is unconscious, so kya hoga? The tongue falls back and there is obstruction of the airway. So patient can die. So aapko initially, agar aap koi bhi management dekhoge, in trauma also, first you have to secure the airway circulation and breathing. Okay. So this is one. Then of course, what are the clinical features? Common sense hai, injury hai, chot lagi hai, kya hoga? Swelling, pain rahega. Wahan pe aap palpate karoge, patient ko pain hoga. So that is tender on palpation. There will be soft tissue injuries, right? So let's see aur kya kya hai. Fracture hai, there will be step deformity because of the muscle pull. There is a deranged occlusion and you will see step deformity. Not only in the occlusion, if you palpate in the inferior border of the mandible, you're going to feel the notable step deformity. Okay, because the bone is being displaced like this. Okay, so occlusion mein we have that step deformity, and if you palpate the inferior border of the mandible, you're going to feel the step deformity at the inferior border. It is tender on palpation, malocclusion rahega. Of course, the segment will be mobile because it was fractured. Hai. Anna. Another thing. So what is this? Dono side pe? Inferior alveolar nerve. Mandibular canal, but yeah, inferior alveolar nerve hai usme. From the mandibular foramen to the mental foramen. Hai na? So suppose aapne kuch nahi dekha, patient ne bas aake bola, mujhe yahan pe maar lagi thi, and I have numbness in the lip region. You can be sure to say ki is region mein fracture hua hai, right? Because if the fracture occurs after the, that is distal to the mandibular foramen, एंड प्रॉक्सिमल टू द मेंटल फोरामेन, इस पोर्शन में फ्रैक्चर हुआ है, देन यू कैन से फॉर श्योर कि पैरेसिशिया होगा. नाउ पैरेसिशिया सब में नहीं होता है. सपोज फ्रैक्चर हुआ बट इट डजंट गेट डिस्प्लेस्ड, ओके, फ्रैक्चर बोन में हुआ है बट इट डजंट गेट डिस्प्लेस्ड, तो दे वोंट बी एनी नर्व इंजरी. समझ रहे हो? नर्व इंजरी कब होगी? जब फ्रैक्चर डिस्प्लेस होकर उसको पुल कर रहा है. देर इज इन्फ्लेमेशन एंड प्रेशर ओवर द नर्व. ओके, नर्व इंजरी लेक्चर याद हो तो. सो इवन इफ देर इज फ्रैक्चर इन द रीजन, अगर डिस्प्लेसमेंट नहीं है, देर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी यू माइट नॉट सी पैरेस्थीसिया. बट इफ देर इज पैरेस्थीसिया, यू कैन से फॉर श्योर कि फ्रैक्चर इस रीजन में. ओके, समझ आया? सो ऐसे आप याद रखो एनाटॉमी से. सो पैरेस्थीसिया दिखेगा, या इन दिस केस द पेशेंट इज गोइंग टू हैव पैरेस्थीसिया बिकॉज द मेंटल फोरामेन इज हियर. So the fracture is proximal to the mental foramen. Then paresthesia Coleman sign. This is especially seen in cases of symphysis and parasymphysis fracture. Basically, lingual cortex is fractured, and lingual cortex and lingual periosteum is torn. Because of that, there is ecchymosis, collection of blood in the lingual mucosa, floor of the mouth, and you see the collection of blood in this region. That is Coleman sign. Okay. Then we have Battle sign. This is especially seen in condylar fracture. Okay. नॉट ओनली कॉन्डाइलो फ्रैक्चर, अगर कॉन्डाइल फ्रैक्चर नहीं भी हुआ है, सपोज द फोर्स अप्लाइड है, दिस फोर्स इज अप्लाइड टू द मैस्टॉइड हेयर सेल्स एंड वहां पे वी हैव एकाइमोसिस पोस्ट ऑरिकुलर रीजन. ओके, देन अगेन जो मैंने बताया सॉफ्ट टिश्यू इंजरीज, लैसरेशन हो सकता है बिकॉज ऑफ द पेन एंड स्वेलिंग एंड बिकॉज ऑफ इंजरी ऑल्सो. इंजरी है, देर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी दैट मसल्स माइट गो इन टू स्पाजम, दैट कैन कॉज टू लिमिटेड ओपनिंग एंड ट्रेस्मस, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ पेन there will be limited mouth opening, patient को pain हो रहा है, वो mouth open नहीं करेगा. And of course, जो मैंने explain किया था bilateral parasymphysis fracture में, there will be tongue fall back, that can be life threatening. So ये ध्यान रखना होता है. So what are the different reasons for mandible fracture? Common sense है, motor vehicle accident, गाड़ी चला रहे हैं, helmet नहीं पहना है, accident हो गया, you have the injury in the head and neck region. Industrial accident, remember industrial accidents होते हैं. Then sports injury, example मैंने बताया हुआ है. Interpersonal violence, एक दूसरे से झगड़ रहे हैं, यहाँ पे बहुत सारे example students में भी हमने देखे हैं, है ना? And guardsman fracture, I've already talked about. The during long parades in afternoon session, the guardman, the soldier, he might faint and fall down. Because of that, you will see symphysis along with bilateral condyle fracture. Okay, so this is यहाँ पे सही से दिख नहीं रहा, but we have the symphysis fracture, and this you can see. Bilateral condylar fracture. Okay. Then we have something called as buckle handle fracture. This is especially seen in cases where the patient, the mandible is edentulous one, and it is very resorbed. The ridge is very resorbed. So even with the external trauma, se the fracture ho sakta, but usually it is seen with because of the muscle pull. Muscle pull ki wajah se it gets broken and pulled downwards. So this is called as bucket handle fracture. So what are the radiographs taken for diagnosing a fracture? Most common is OPG, of course. OPG mein pura mandible easily visualize ho jata hai, right? And nowadays these are the two radiological investigation that can be done, that are preferred nowadays. Okay, OPG and CT phase. Now CT phase mein we have proper slices along with the 3D reconstruction. We'll cover them. So this is CT scan. You can see axial section and you can see the fracture in the left parasymphysis region. This is this coronal section showing the angle fracture. Okay, so again this is a 3D reconstruction that is showing the right subcondylar fracture. Okay, so this is quite good. If possible, always get a CT phase done, and uske baad second choice is OPG. And agar ye dono cheeze available nahi hai, then we have different examples, different views that can be done. Time kam hai to main detail mein nahi jaunga. Symphysis, parasymphysis, if you're suspecting, then you can go for PA view mandible. Body angle ramus hai, then you can go for lateral oblique plus PA view. And condyle hai, to reverse down view kar sakte hain. Lateral oblique is basically, I have the image, I think. I don't have the images. Yeah. Okay, so basically, film is like this. Patient ka head aise tilt karte hain, X-ray beam goes like this. And this is what the image you're going to get. Okay, so कॉन्डाइल में रिवर्स डाउन व्यू रहता है और पीए व्यू यूज कर सकते हैं. वी कैन यूज अक्लूजल व्यू ऑल्सो. यू कैन सी स्पेशली इन द बॉडी एंड द सिम्फाइसिस पैरासिम्फाइसिस रीजन टू डिटेक्ट मीडियोलैटरल डिस्प्लेसमेंट. ओके, नाउ वी कम टू कॉन्डाइल फ्रैक्चर. कॉन्डाइल फ्रैक्चर डिटेल में नहीं जाऊंगा. आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन. देर आर अ फ्यू कंसेप्ट जो मैं तुम्हें एक्सप्लेन करना चाहता हूँ. स्पेशली अगेन द सेम थिंग जो मैंने बताई थी, Condyle fracture कब होगा? When this is absent, third molar is absent. If third molar is present, there is a possibility that angle fracture is going to happen. If third molar is absent, then condyle fracture होगा. Okay? Now, you'll see that in some cases of condyle fracture, you're going to see ipsilateral open bite, and in some cases, you're going to see opposite side, contralateral open bite. Okay? How do you decide कौन से cases में कैसा दिखता है? So basically, condyle head fracture है. The head is inside the capsule, capsular ligament, right? So if the head is fractured, उसमें क्या होगा? There is bleeding, but it is getting collected inside the capsule. वो बाहर नहीं आ रहा है. So the hematoma is collected inside the capsule, and because of the blood collection in the capsule, there is hemarthrosis, collection of blood in the joint space. Okay? And because of that collection of blood, वो it is pushing the condyle, the ramus downwards. ठीक है? अंदर बीच में collect होता जा रहा है. It is applying pressure over the condyle, the ramus. It is being pushed down. Now, there is blood, hematoma, and we have the ramus. And condyle head fracture है तो बहुत minimal height reduction होता है. So we have increase in the height in this region. Okay? So when the patient opens mouth, deviation is towards the opposite side. In case of condyle head, hemarthrosis जब होगा. One and second, because of the increased height, we have the open bite on same side. When the patient closes the mouth, that is one scenario. Second है when we have the subcondylar और condylar neck fracture, that is outside extracapsular fracture. This was intracapsular, this is extracapsular. Okay, so condylar neck or subcondylar fracture, it is extracapsular. Okay, so bleeding हो भी रहा, it is not getting collected inside the capsule. बाहर है, it gets diffused. So क्या होगा? The fracture, the condylar head is, it gets displaced and the height is reduced. Okay, so when the patient closes mouth, the on the same side the posterior teeth they meet prematurely. तो अपोजिट साइड पे प्रॉपर अक्लूजन हो ही नहीं पा रहा है, सेम साइड पे प्रीमैच्योर कांटेक्ट हो रहा है. ओके, दैट इज वन. सो इन दिस केस इंट्राकैप्सुलर फ्रैक्चर वी हैव द ओपन बाइट ऑन द सेम साइड, दैट इज इप्सिलैटरल. इन केस ऑफ एक्स्ट्राकैप्सुलर फ्रैक्चर वी हैव द ओपन बाइट ऑन द अपोजिट साइड. ओके, इन दिस व्हेन द पेशेंट ओपन्स माउथ द डिविएशन इज टुवर्ड्स द अपोजिट साइड. इन दिस व्हेन द पेशेंट ट्राइज टू ओपन माउथ, यहां पे हाइट कम होने की वजह से डिविएशन इज टुवर्ड्स द सेम साइड. ओके, सिंपल इनफ. Okay? Now, अगर दोनों bilateral condylar fracture है तो क्या होगा? Condylar neck fracture. दोनों side पे height reduce हो गई, तो दोनों side पे premature contact होगा in the posterior teeth. Okay? So anterior open bite रहेगा. समझ आया? So posteriorly there is premature contact, anterior open bite रहेगा. It stays open. This is the concept I wanted you guys to understand. And then of course clinical features में battle sign रहेगा. Depending on the fracture, intracapsular, extracapsular, there will be malocclusion, cross bite. Deviation, open bite, anterior open bite, this is the deviation. So basically आप anatomy याद रखो, the biomechanics याद रखो, आप clinical features खुद लिख पाओगे. Okay? So after the fracture occurs and if you go for close reduction, close reduction का क्या मतलब है? Normally what we do is आचवार place कर दिया, IMF कर दिया. ठीक है? हमने कुछ नहीं किया, बस let's go back. In this case, suppose bilateral condyle में हमने बस ये तो बहुत ज्यादा डिस्प्लेसमेंट दिखा. नॉर्मली इट इज मीडियली डिविएटेड फ्रैक्चर्स, नॉर्मल वो दिखता है. तो दोनों साइड पे हल्का सा डिविएशन हो गया है एंड इसी में हमने आईएमएफ करके रख दिया एंड वी आर नॉट अलाउइंग द सेगमेंट्स टू मूव एंड द फ्रैक्चर सेगमेंट्स दे फ्यूज इन दैट डिविएटेड पोजिशन. सो उसके बाद क्या क्या अडेप्टेशन होते हैं? द बॉडी ट्राइज टू रिगेन इट्स ओरिजिनल फॉर्म. कैसे होता है? आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू दैट. ओके, सो देर आर फ्यू अडेप्टेशन. Basically, the body wants to function properly, ho, that we can chew properly, the teeth can come into occlusion properly, right? So, there are three adaptation, neuromuscular, skeletal and dental. And basically, fracture hai, height reduce ho gayi hai, and because of this, ye aise rotate ho gaya mandible, hai na? That is why we have the open bite and premature contact posteriorly, right? Because of the reduced height. Now, what happens is, the body realizes, okay, there is some issue with the occlusion. So, there are three fibers in the temporalis muscle. Anterior fibers that are pulling the mandible upward and forward. Middle fiber upward and posterior fiber that are pulling the mandible and rotating backwards. So, isko aise pull kar raha hai, ye wale fibers. So, what happens is, with time, these posterior fibers, they become stronger. Okay, and they force the mandible to rotate. Okay, pehle because of the reduced height, ye close nahi ho raha tha. But now, because of these fibers getting stronger, we are forcing the mandible to rotate. So, ye open bite kam ho gaya, that is one. Okay? So, posterior temporalis fibers, they force the mandible to rotate. सेकेंड स्केलेटल अडेप्टेशन होता है. सो दिस वॉज न्यूरोमस्कुलर अडेप्टेशन दैट द पोस्टीरियर फाइबर ऑफ टेम्पोरालिस मसल दे आर गेटिंग स्ट्रॉन्गर. देन वी हैव स्केलेटल अडेप्टेशन. कैन यू सी दिस इज द डिविएशन. ओके, इसको ऐसी पोजिशन में हमने हील होने दिया. ओके, नाउ द बॉडी नोज ओके द हाइट इज रिड्यूस, वी नीड द टीथ टू बी इन ऑक्लूजन फॉर प्रॉपर फंक्शन. सो वॉट हैपन्स इज ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम देर हैव बीन मेनी रिसर्चेस डन जिसमें रेगुलरली हमने सीटी स्कैन किए हैं पेशेंट के एंड वी फाउंड आउट दैट इन सच केसेज वॉट हैपन्स इज द बॉडी इट रिजॉल्व्स द मीडियल सर्फेस एंड lays more bone on the lateral surface. So it is, you can say, reshaping the condylar head and trying to achieve its original form. Okay, exactly original form nahi hoga, but it will be much better. Okay, so this is skeletal adaptation, that medially resolve ho raha, laterally there is new bone formation. Okay, so this is skeletal adaptation. Then we have dental adaptation. Ki maine bataya tha, we have teeth that are not in occlusion, right? So what is going to happen? एक तो है कि muscular neuromuscular adaptation that mandible is being rotated. Still this is not going to be enough to achieve proper occlusion. Second thing is dental occlusion, in which what happens is the posterior teeth they intrude inside. So these move upward, these move downward, whereas anteriors they extrude. Okay? So these are trying, ये ऊपर आ रहे हैं, ये नीचे आ रहे हैं. So क्या होगा? Occlusion में आ जाएंगे ये. So in combination to this and dental adaptation, we are achieving the occlusion. This happens usually in bilateral condylar fracture. The body tries to adapt to the new condition. Okay, samajh aaya? Three adaptations: neuromuscular, skeletal, and dental. Okay. Now, what are the objectives of any fracture management? ABC maintain karna hai, airway, breathing, circulation. Okay, that is for emergency management. Once that is stabilized, we are going to reduce the fracture. Now, कोई भी फ्रैक्चर होगा, आपने हाथ पैर कोई भी फ्रैक्चर देखा हो, उसमें क्या करते हैं इनिशियली? इधर इफ इट इज क्लोज रिडक्शन, वी जस्ट प्लेस द कास्ट, वी प्लास्टर लगा देते हैं एंड वी अलाउ टू नॉट मूव सो दैट दीज फ्यूज इन प्रॉपर पोजिशन. ओके, देन सेकेंड ऑप्शन इज ज्यादा डिस्प्लेसमेंट है तो वी ओपन इट अप, वी प्लेस अ प्लेट सो दैट वो दोनों मूव ना हो. ओके, द सेम थिंग वी आर, द मेन एम इज कोई भी सर्जरी का, दैट the first primary goal is to achieve function, proper function. Secondary, uske baad second goal hota hai to achieve proper, not form, aesthetics. Okay? So that is one. So basically, hamara jab hum mandible reduce kar rahe hain ya operate kar rahe hain, the aim is to achieve proper occlusion so that the patient can bite. Uske baad we have the aim, second ki, proper form. Form means aesthetics, or form means कि प्रॉपर अलाइनमेंट में है. द फर्स्ट एम इज द टीथ आर इन ऑक्लूजन, सेकंड एम इज दैट द बोन सेगमेंट्स आर इन प्रॉपर अलाइनमेंट. ओके ओके, सो दीज आर द मेथड्स ऑफ फ्रैक्चर मैनेजिंग फ्रैक्चर, क्लोज एंड ओपन. क्लोज में आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट दिस, ये सब टेक्स्ट बुक में पढ़ लेना, एडवांटेजेस डिसएडवांटेजेस. ओके, सो द इमरजेंसी मैनेजमेंट में इफ वी फील दैट द पेशेंट हैज अ फ्रैक्चर, वी कैन गो फॉर ब्रिडल वायरिंग फॉर इमरजेंसी मैनेजमेंट. दैट अगर फ्रैक्चर को ऐसे ही रहने दिया, द फ्रैक्चर सेगमेंट विल मूव एंड द पेशेंट विल हैव पेन, है ना? तो व्हाट वी कैन डू इज, दिस इज द फ्रैक्चर लाइन, सो वी कैन इन्वॉल्व टू टीथ ऑन बोथ द साइड्स. वी जस्ट इन्वॉल्व द टू टीथ ऑन बोथ द साइड्स ऑफ द फ्रैक्चर एंड वी जस्ट टाइटन द वायर. ओके, सो वी आर प्रिवेंटिंग द फ्रैक्चर सेगमेंट फ्रॉम मूविंग. अब प्रॉपर पोजिशन में नहीं है, डजंट मैटर, बिकॉज दिस इज इमरजेंसी मैनेजमेंट. ओके, देन सेकेंड इज, दिस इज ऑल्सो बायलैटरल पैरासिम्फाइसिस फ्रैक्चर एंड ब्रिडल वायरिंग. Then we have Barton's bandage, then we have four-tail bandage. Basically, we are preventing movement in the fracture segments. Okay? Then there are different methods of IMF and close reduction. Okay? This is Gilmer's wiring. Eyelets, eyelets may be different types, that IV, Williams, Helms modification, club hitch. Then we have residence wiring, arch bar. Arch bar ke bhi alag-alag types hain, Jelenko, Eric's arch bar. In kids, especially in kids, pediatric mandible fracture, we prefer a cap splint. We prefer not to open up the fracture site. First is, when last time explained, kiya tha, we are going to hamper the blood supply, leading to hampered growth. That is one. And second, we have the tooth buds in the region. Agar hum wahan pe plate karenge, plate karne ke liye holes banane padte hain, we might damage the tooth bud. So in pediatric patient, it is preferred that we don't open up the surgical site. We manage it with the cap splint. इसको फिक्स कैसे करेंगे आगे की स्लाइड में दिखाएंगे. सो वन ऑप्शन इज कैप स्प्लिंट. इन ओल्डर इंडिविजुअल वी कैन यूज अ गनिंग स्प्लिंट. वी टुक द इंप्रेशन ऑफ द पेशेंट एंड फ्रैक्चर साइट पे वी ब्रेक द कास्ट, रिड्यूस इट इन प्रॉपर पोजीशन एंड देन उसके ऊपर वी मेक द splint, gunning splint, and gunning splint ke upar we can stick the arch bar and we can achieve the IMF. Okay, and isko fix kaise karenge? We place the splint and we insert the bone all from the lingual side, inferior mandible se, extra orally we insert it from here, inferior border se. We go on the lingual side, bone all sui dhage ki tarah hota hai, sui ki tarah hota hai, usme ek hole hota hai at the tip. We insert the wire in it and twist it. We pull it down, we don't pull it out completely of the soft tissue. Yahan laake we just pull it here. So the wire is being pulled and around the mandible. Okay, once it is taken out from this side, can you see it is being pulled out from this side? Once it is out, we can twist the wire and fix the splint in position. Okay, then open reduction hai, we are going to open the site surgically. Theek hai, fracture segment hai. If we make sure that the fracture segments are in proper position to each other, anatomical position mein, automatically the teeth are going to be in occlusion. Okay, so open reduction ke methods hain, different plates systems hote hain. The most commonly used system is mini plates and screws. Okay, so these are the mini plates and screws. Isme yaad rakhna hai that we should try to place one plate at the inferior border, second at least 5 mm subapically, root hai jo, the root of the tooth, uske 5 mm below we are going to place the second plate. Okay, remember that. Then we have dynamic compression plate. So these dynamic compression plates, they force the segments, jo micro gap bhi hai wo bhi close kar dete hain. I'll show you the animation. So these are the dynamic compression plates, already holes bana diye, and you can see there's a gap here at the fracture site. So when we tighten the screws, can you see these segments are being pushed towards each other? So these are dynamic compression plate. But now dynamic compression plates mein kya, the movement is being done in only one direction, that is here dono ek dusre ki taraf pull ho rahe hain, that is it. But mandible, it is a 3D structure, curved hai. So kya hoga, there is something, there's a modification of dynamic compression plate, that is eccentric dynamic compression plate, in which middle screws are pushing the segment towards each other, whereas these last two screws, they are pushing the, they are rotating the segments upwards. Okay, so jab isko tight karenge, these segments are pulled towards each other. But as you if you remember, upper tensile force hota, they are being pushed away from each other. So when we tighten these screws, these segments are pushed towards each other. Okay, so we are just with one plate, we are countering the compressive and tensile forces. Okay, so these are eccentric dynamic compression plates. Then we have reconstruction plate. A reconstruction plate is used in cases if it is comminuted and you have to open it up, or atrophic mandible hai, that wahan pe aap simple mini plate se nahi kar paoge. In those cases we use reconstruction plate. It is a very thick plate and it is a load bearing. Ha, there is a concept that is load bearing and load sharing jo maine cover nahi kiya hai. Basically load bearing kya hota hai ki the plate aapne laga di and the plate will be alone able to bear the forces of the occlusion, that is load bearing. Load sharing hota hai that we have brought the fracture segment close to each other as much as possible and we plate them, and the force, the occlusal force is being borne by the bone along with the mini plates or the plates. Okay, that is load sharing. So this is a example of load bearing. Again, the reconstruction plate, you can compare, these are mini plate, these are, this is a reconstruction plate. Look at the comparison, size comparison dekho, this is very thick and large. Okay, then we have something called as TORC, that is titanium coated hollow screw and reconstruction plate system. Okay, isme kya hota hai, it is similar to a reconstruction plate, but jo screws hote hain, they are osseo integrated, titanium hota hai and they are hollow. So when we put it inside the bone, they get osseo integrated, so minimal movement hota hai. Isme there is a possibility of micro movement, this might fail. Okay, but this may, the chances of failure are very less. Then we have locking plates. So this is a normal screw and this is a screw for locking plate. Can you see isme threads and neck pe? Okay, and these threads, they go and tighten into this, okay, the plate. So these are locking plates. Then we have Champy's line, wo maine already explained kar diya. Basically we have the tensile forces, compressive forces at the inferior border, and Champy says in the symphysis and parasymphysis you should plate two plates at inferior border and here subapically, whereas in the body region you can plate only in one region, that is slightly above the mandibular canal and below the apex of the teeth. Okay, this is the site, this is going to be enough for this side, for stabilization of this side. And this, you can see yahan pe do lines ja rahi in the angle region, इट डजंट मीन कि दोनों में प्लेट करना है. व्हाट ही सेज इज या तो यू कैन प्लेट एट द सुपीरियर बॉर्डर और एट द लैटरल सर्फेस ऑफ द रेमस. ओके, इट इज प्रिफर्ड दैट वी कैन प्लेट इन दिस रीजन एंटीरियर बॉर्डर ऑफ द रेमस. क्यों? बिकॉज इफ यू प्लेट इट हियर, इफ यू रिमेंबर कंप्रेस टेंसाइल फोर्स इज पुलिंग द सेगमेंट्स अवे फ्रॉम ईच अदर एंड दीज आर बींग पुश्ड टुवर्ड्स ईच अदर. ओके, सो इफ यू प्लेस अ प्लेट हियर, so you are preventing them from moving away from each other, but yahan pe to they are already being pressed towards each other because of the muscle forces. So this is enough for stabilization of this fracture site. Only one plate is enough. Okay, so this is the same thing jo maine pehle bataya tha. I'm not going to go into the details. Champy's line, and then this is something that is not used anymore, but historical importance ke liye you should know, that is external pin fixation. We insert the pins through the skin. Okay, and then we fix it with the bar. Okay, then approaches alag alag rahenge, intraoral and extraoral. This is extraoral submandibular and retromandibular. This is intraoral vestibular incision. Okay, iske alawa bhi bahut sare hote hain. For condyle we have preauricular, retroauricular, rhytidectomy, bahut sare approaches hain, wo textbook mein pad lena. Okay, so I'm going to show you some clinical cases jo hamare department mein kiye gaye. This is one of the cases where we took the CT scan of the patient. उसको हमने प्रिंट किया एंड वी रिड्यूस्ड इट एंड ऑन टॉप ऑफ दैट वी क्रिएटेड अ स्प्लिंट. ओके, दिस वाज डन बिफोर आई जॉइंड द कॉलेज. ये हेमंत सर ने किया था. सो यू कैन सी कैप स्प्लिंट बना दी एंड ये कर दिया. नाउ दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट इन दिस. क्यों? क्योंकि नॉर्मली इट हिस्टोरिकली इट वॉज डन बाय टेकिंग इंप्रेशन ऑफ द पेशेंट्स डेंटिशियन. नाउ पेशेंट इज अ चाइल्ड, उसका इंप्रेशन इन दिस कंडीशन वेयर ही हैज अ फ्रैक्चर, पेनफुल कंडीशन में पेशेंट इंप्रेशन नहीं लेने देते. सो दिस इज अ वेरी गुड ऑप्शन दैट कैन बी डन. ओके, देन सबकॉन्डाइल फ्रैक्चर. या अनदर थिंग आई फॉरगॉट टू टेल यू कि अगर बायलैटरल कॉन्डाइल फ्रैक्चर है, एंटीरियर ओपन बाइट है. ओके, सो आर्च बार प्लेस करके व्हाट यू कैन डू इज, नॉर्मली बिकॉज ऑफ द मसल पुल, दीज मसल्स आर सो स्ट्रॉन्ग, आप हाथ से भी दबाओगे ना, नॉर्मली अक्लूजन नहीं आ पाएगा. सो व्हाट यू कैन डू इज, आर्च बार लगा के यू कैन प्लेस इलास्टिक्स. कैन यू सी इलास्टिक्स यहाँ पे दिख रहे हैं? ये तो जस्ट यहाँ पे दिखा रहे हैं दो तीन इलास्टिक, बट इमेजिन आर्च बार है, हमने बहुत सारी इलास्टिक्स लगा दी. ओके, नॉर्मली दीज मसल्स आर एक्टिव बिकॉज ऑफ द पेन, ट्रिसमस में है. ओके, स्पैज़म में है, दे प्रिवेंटिंग द दिस मैंडिबल बीइंग रोटेटेड एंड ब्रॉट इनटू ऑक्लूजन. सो नाउ आपने ऑलरेडी आर्च बार प्लेस करके इलास्टिक्स लगा दिया. नाउ व्हेन द पेशेंट गोज टू स्लीप, द मसल्स दे रिलैक्स एंड दिस इलास्टिक्स आर गोइंग टू पुल द टीथ इनटू द जॉ इनटू ऑक्लूजन. ओके, सो दिस इज व्हाट आई डू इन केसेस ऑफ द कॉन्डाइल फ्रैक्चर, बायलैटरल और यूनिलैटरल. मैं आठ बार प्लेस करके इलास्टिक डाल के छोड़ देता हूँ फॉर 24 आवर्स. आई रिकॉल द पेशेंट द नेक्स्ट डे एंड देन आई रिप्लेस द इलास्टिक्स विद आईएमएफ वायर्स. ओके, सो दिस, देन वी हैव राइट पैरासिम्फैसियल लेफ्ट सबकॉन्डाइलर फ्रैक्चर. इसमें भी यू कैन सी द प्लेटिंग इज डन. वी ट्राइड टू रीच. नाउ देयर इज वन प्रॉब्लम, आप हमारे यहाँ के केसेस देखोगे, दिस आइडियली आपने टेक्स्ट बुक में पढ़ा दैट दिस प्लेट शुड बी एट द इन्फीरियर बॉर्डर. Some cases you might not find them at the inferior border. Reason, क्योंकि intraorally हम जा रहे हैं, it is very difficult to access the inferior border. Okay, तो जितना नीचे जा सकते हैं वहां पे जाके plate कर देते हैं. Now this is a good case. Again the same thing. Condyle में, yeah, I forgot to mention that. Suppose there's a subcondylar fracture. Okay, so either ideally what you are supposed to do is place one plate at the posterior border of the ramus. Second is going to be parallel to the sigmoid notch. So two plates are to be placed like this. But there's a new plate, that is delta plate, that acts as two plate. Okay, ek ye aise place kar diya, this is like one like this and this is like this. Okay, so it is acting as two plates, whereas it is only one. Okay, this is one case that I would like to show you, jo hamara maine kiya hai. So basically we take the patient CT scan and we convert it into a 3D model. CT scan se humne ye 3D model extract kiya. You can see right parasymphysis and left fracture hai, left angle fracture hai. So we took it into a software and we reduced the fractures. Usko fracture reduce kiya. Now we want to 3D print it. Ab 3D print pura karenge, material zyada waste hoga, but we are interested only in the angle and parasymphysis. So I extracted the angle and parasymphysis and usko humne print kiya. And basically the mandible mid face, sari bones jo hai face ki, they are 3D, not straight. So plates ko adapt karna padta hai. Okay, so during the surgery it takes a lot of time to adapt these plates properly to the bone. Okay, so what we have done here is CT scan se mandible extract kiya 3D and usko humne reduce kar diya computer mein and then we printed it. Okay, and uske upar humne plate before the surgery humne adapt kar liya. So we are reducing the surgery time. Okay, so दिस वॉज सो इजी कि मैंने ग्लव्स भी नहीं पहने, बहुत ही ऑपरेटेड द पेशेंट बाय हिमसेल्फ एंड ही वॉज एबल टू अचीव प्रॉपर रिडक्शन. कैन यू सी नाउ दीज प्लेट्स, प्री बेंड प्लेट, दे ऑल्सो एक्ट एज अ गाइड कि रिडक्शन सही से हुआ है कि नहीं, बिकॉज आपने कंप्यूटर में रिडक्शन कर लिया एंड द प्लेट्स आर बीइंग बेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट रिड्यूस्ड फ्रैक्चर सेगमेंट्स. ओके, सो इफ दीज प्लेट्स आर नॉट बीइंग adapted properly in the surgery, that means the fracture segments are not reduced properly. Okay, so these are the images from the surgical the surgery. Intraoral vestibular incision in the parasymphysis and angle region. This angle region ka jo incision hai, it is similar to the Watts incision, and the plating and suturing was done with 30 Vicryl.